Welcome to the tutorial of configuring an STM330 module. Let us start with preparations. For this you will need an EDK300, an STM330 and an EDK310 kit. Make sure the TCM320 is plugged into the EVA300 board. In this tutorial we will also use DolphinView with a connected gateway controller and DolphinStudio. Make sure the TCM is programmed with the gateway controller firmware. The STM330 is a ready-to-use temperature sensor. In the example, we will configure the wake-up cycles, retransmission parameters, and profile parameters. It is shipped with a mounted jumper that ensures that the Learn button has a pull-up. To configure it, we remove the jumper and plug it into the EVA330. The STM330 is already programmed. What we are going to do is to configure it by writing selected values into its configuration area. To configure the module, use DolphinStudio and a programmer connected to an evaluation board 330. DolphinStudio has an interface to configure modules. We just have to select the correct device. Before starting the configuration, read out the present values. Then you can start writing your own. As EEP, we select a simple temperature sensor with a range from 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. The manufacturer ID specifies the manufacturer. If you do not have a manufacturer ID, use the multi-user ID. The sensor measures the value at every wake-up. Only if there is a significant change compared to previous values, it transmits a data telegram. A significant change is defined by a threshold value. One unit is about 0.16 degrees Celsius, so if we enter 7, it is a little bit above 1 degree. If there is no significant change, the sensor checks if a retransmission of the same value, a sort of still alive signal, should be sent. For example, we can specify that if there was no significant change 5 times in a row, we do a retransmission. To prevent periodical sending, we can also specify a minimum and maximum range of cycles in which the retransmission should happen. The STM then picks a random number from this range. Set the wake-up cycle to 1 second. Write the configuration. Disconnect the STM330 from the EVA and we are done configuring. Now we have a fully configured STM, so let's test it. Put the previously removed jumper back. Make sure the STM is charged. Normally it is enough to let it charge for several minutes on your desk. Switch to DolphinView and connect to the gateway controller. By clicking on the Learn button, a Learn telegram is transmitted. It tells the receiver how to interpret the data sent by the sensor. This telegram includes the EnOcean equipment profile number. DolphinView recognizes the EEP profile. Make sure the EEP matches the previously set values. If you do not see any measurement values on the graph, just wait for 5 seconds for the next retransmission. If no significant change has occurred, the module waits for the next retransmission cycle. To trigger a significant change, you can put your module into a fridge. We are using cooling spray. As the temperature falls, we see a transmission every second. The STM module can also be configured using the hardware pins. With the pins, we can set up the wake-up cycle and the retransmission range. To activate the hardware pin settings, we have to assign these parameters default values in DolphinStudio, otherwise the hardware settings would be ignored. There are two configuration pins. By putting the pin on ground or letting it unconnected, we have 4 possible configurations. Consult the STM330 manual for details. With a similar approach, you can also configure other STM modules like the STM300 or the STM310. The logic behind wake-up cycles and retransmission stays the same, but there are more parameters to set. The STM31X has no default hardware settings. Instead, you can define 4 configurations of wake-up cycles and retransmission ranges. With these modules, you can measure up to 3 analog and digital inputs. Additionally, there is the ADIO2 pin, which can either be an analog input or measure the quarter voltage of the VDD supply. You can configure the delay between software power on and the sampling moment of the external sensor and power the sensor only for the necessary time. This concludes our tutorial.